Hello everybody, Faisal Talpur here. Hope you're well. Just wanted to bring to you something which has been working really, really well for me recently. I have got into the business of consulting. Surprise, surprise. As you know, people who know me for the last few years, for the last 10 years, in fact, I've been running various businesses, you know, that includes technology, media and marketing. I've put some of them there. And I have been doing some comparison on different businesses, and I've just realized that, you know, consulting by far stands out. A few years ago, 3-4 years ago, if somebody was to ask me what consulting is or what a consulting business is, I used to come across so many business consultants. To my amazement, I would not understand when they'd say, okay, you know what, I'm actually a business consultant. Why? I don't know, because it's such a big field. It was very difficult for me to understand, because it was perhaps difficult for some of these people to define to me as to what actual space they're in. Having said that, I put my skepticism aside, and I naturally ventured into consulting, because when I was running these different businesses, I used to get asked by my friends, my colleagues, help us out with this, help us out with that. And before I knew it, I was actually in it without knowing I was in it, if you understand my drift. So that's exactly what it was. So it was literally a natural progression into this business. When I came into this business, as in when I started consulting, you know, what I realized was that this was actually a very good business to be in. So I started to put a structure together. I started to put certain workflows together. I started to put a framework around it as to, you know, how I can make it productive, how I can make it efficient, how I can actually make it work for me. And little did I know that I was onto something, and I realized that this actually is a business which perhaps almost anybody can get into, anybody can do, without having too much hassle, without having any products, without having much of a service background. As long as you have got some skills that you're happy to put out there and help people out there, that's exactly what it is. It's a consulting business for you. So recently, what we've started doing is that I have actually taken a step forward, whereby I have got my own, of course, my own consulting business, but I've taken a step forward whereby we are now setting up consulting businesses for others. That is what has been working very, very well. So let me explain to you why I think consulting business is a good business to be in. And obviously, I don't know you, so I'm not sure exactly what your circumstances are, how old you are, you know, what your expertise is. But having said that, let me tell you how I felt and why I felt the consulting business was good as compared to so many other businesses out there. Just to give you a super quick business background of myself, I've actually been into all these different businesses, and I've tried and tested a few others which are not listed here. But I can gladly compare the consulting business with all these different businesses that I've run. At some point in time, some of them are still active and I'm still running. So that's property investments, finance, import-export, forex trading, call center, customer services, right? Running a call center, as you can imagine, is not an easy one. Online e-commerce stores, this one is much more beneficial as compared to that. Software technology, which we still run actively and we sell software globally. Media and marketing business, again, we have got a brand media and marketing agency, which is quite a successful agency. And I still would say consulting business has been the best so far. So this is my personal experience of running all these different businesses. So I would say all these businesses put aside, and consulting business put aside. And there's so many benefits to it, which I have personally experienced, and I'm gonna share those benefits with you today. So why I have loved it and why I think you should love it as well, is these are the benefits which I've personally experienced, and I've extracted some of these benefits for you to understand today what they are. So time freedom. One of the first thing that I thought was best about consulting was the time and the freedom that it gave me, right? Because what I understood was that, you know, in different businesses, I was very much restricted in terms of time. With consulting, it was very much of, you know, I call the shot. So I set up my diary, I set up almost my client's diary, and you know, we come together we discuss things, and you know, and that could be after every week and a half, 2 weeks or so, and that's the way it works. So it gives me a lot of time freedom. Also, it gives my client a lot of time freedom as well, because he gets the time to do what he's got to do. And the other thing is, for me personally, is that I can take time off from the business, so I can take myself out of the business for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, without hampering anything, without hampering my own work or my client's work. So you know, so time freedom is one of the most important ones, and I think that's, you know, in different stages of our life, we are looking for freedom that we can get when it comes to work, when it comes to our business. So that, for me, that's one of the best ones. Manageable low stress. Now, this is another thing. You see, when you are getting into business, or you already are in business, or you are, you know, you're doing what you're doing, what you love doing, stress is a very important part, which is ignored by a lot of people. And before you know it, you're in it. And that causes, that becomes a major cause for a lot of disruption in our life. And this is another beauty of this business, is that it actually can be managed in such a way that, you know, you don't have to face or come across a lot of stress, especially with the kind of framework that we have put together, whereby, you know, we match the clients as per your expertise. So, you know, so the framework that that we have got is whereby you we extract your skill set, your expertise, your experiences, we bring that out, and then we convert that into a business, and then we go out there fetching the right kind of clients for you. So if you're dealing with the right kind of people, if you're dealing with like-minded people, then it's very difficult for you to get into a stressful situation, because it's you know, everybody's working for the mutual benefit. So that's the manageable low stress side of things. You've got an easy to sell structure. Now, the good thing about consulting, I find, is that you do not have to get into product development as such, right? So you're not looking to either sell somebody else's product, which in itself can cause a lot of a strain on your business, because, you know, if depending on the product availability and all of that. So, you know, it's a comparatively easy to sell business, because you are not necessarily, you know, selling somebody else's product. You're not making a product yourself. You are selling something which is your own. So you are in control. I would call it comparatively, because a lot of people, for them, any sale or any selling is difficult, right? But especially with the kind of framework that we have got, the selling becomes, you know, a comparatively easy part of the business. Next one is happier clients. Again, like I said, if you know what you're doing, and if you convert that into the business, if you absolutely love what you do, then, you know, psychologically, also, that love is passed on to your clients, right? Because you are in it to make yourself happy, which means your clients become happier, right? And if you are doing it from you know, a genuine perspective, so you're genuinely trying to help them, you're doing it from an ethical perspective, you're being ethical about the business that you're in, then there is no reason why your clients should not be happy. One of the things that we also do in this framework is that we design the package of consulting. And what that also means is that that has got a lot of value, which is given to the, which is then passed over to the client. So if you're charging X amount from the client and you are delivering X plus Y plus Z, then there is no reason why he should not be happy with your service. So, you know, happier clients is what I found this business to have as well. You are ready now. Now, again, I would come back to the point whereby a lot of people that I come across, they say, well, even if I would like to get into consulting, what am I going to actually offer? Well, the best answer I can give for that is that, you know, whatever you're going to offer is something that you already have, right? So you already have that skill set, you already have that experience, you already have that expertise. All that needs to be done is that it needs to be converted in such a way that it can be monetized, so we can go out in the market, get the right clients for yourself, and then obviously, you know, you can monetize at the back of that, right? So you are ready now, so you don't have to get into you know, any extraneous effort of making a product. You've already got that in you. All you need really is self-confidence, an extrovert approach to bring what you've already got to the rest of the world, and they can perhaps come and benefit from what you've got to offer. So, you know, so you're ready, for time to market. My sixth point. Now, time to market, again, is a very interesting one, because, you know, we spend a lot of time before even we get into the business, right? As to say, you know, you know, a lot of people, they spend a lot of time planning. Now, sometimes this planning can go on for years. It's very good to plan, don't get me wrong. But what is not so very good is obviously procrastination, or what is not very good is when your planning becomes too elongated, and before you know it, your mind or your brain starts to talk you out of it. So the time to market is almost imminently now. You can actually go to market with your consulting business tomorrow morning if you like, really, because, you know, whatever you've already got, if you identify this is the skill that I can offer, this is what I can help the businesses with, or even individuals with, then, you know, you are actually ready to go to market now. Okay. Speed in acquiring clients. If you really know what you're doing, and if you really know what you would like to offer, if you really know what you are going to help people with, then acquiring clients is not really a big problem. And, you know, obviously, you know, we've been in internet marketing for over 10 years now. So it's not very difficult to go out there and match the client's requirements to what you have to offer. As long as you know what you're doing, it's not going to be an issue. So, you know, acquiring the clients is fairly relatively easy as compared to a lot of businesses out there. The other thing about consulting is that it can actually be quite niche. So if you know something that you have got an expertise on, and that can be converted, and that is, if that is already a niche, then even better, because to acquire those kind of clients is, you know, makes it slightly easier. Low investment, low risk. Now, I have known of businesses whereby people are investing hundreds of thousands of pounds to get a franchise, or to get a restaurant going, or perhaps even to build a software, right? You know, I know someone who's just literally ended up spending £2 million to build a software, right? Another one I know, he's just spent £1.5 million to build a software. So a lot of people are spending money to have a good, viable, sustainable business, which there's nothing wrong with that, by the way, but that is their approach. If you are not willing to spend too much money, if you're not willing to spend you know, money on, for example, buildings and premises and offices, then again, consulting is for you. What I absolutely found brilliant about low investment, low risk is that my all other businesses listed here costed me a lot more money to get into, to get them going, to get the marketing done, you know, to have a stable business. But with consulting, you can actually stabilize the business in no time, right? And you don't really need a proper premise to be running it. You could be working from home if you want to run a proper consulting business. And, you know, and so that's what it is. Global, this is an interesting one. Now, for a lot of people, they will think, that means I'm going to have to travel a lot. Actually, that's not necessarily true, because depending on the kind of consulting you're providing, you don't necessarily have to physically be there, right? So you could be sitting at home, wherever your home is, and you could be providing a consulting service to the rest of the world, right? Technology allows you to do that. Again, right use of technology at the right time, you know, for the right thing, of course, can do miracles. And that's why you can have, again, almost instantly a global business by providing consulting services to the people who are looking for the kind of service you're going to provide. High net profit. This is an interesting one. It's almost similar to what I said earlier. So, you know, when you are not putting in too much money into buying premises or franchises and this, that, and the other, then obviously you are not spending a lot of money. But the beauty of beauty of consulting is that it gives you, you don't have to recruit a lot of people. You don't have to have X, Y, Z in place for you to go to market, right? So you're not, I mean, you know, you could even be outsourcing some of the services that are part of the consulting service that you're providing. Okay, so yeah, so the cost is very low and the profit can be very high. This is another thing that we actually love to do, which is the way we design the package is we design the package in such a way that the amount of money that you will be making perhaps is much more comparatively profit friendly, should I say, as compared to draining you, which a lot of other businesses do, right? Recurring monthly income. This is my favorite. Okay, so you have businesses whereby you do not have that continuity of money coming every month, and this is where this which causes a lot of, again, by the way, that's also a big stress for a lot of people, because from the first day of the month they start from zero, whereby they have got to think and worry about, goodness me, how this month I start from zero, I'll have to now worry about how am I going to be paying my bills, how am I going to be approaching clients, how am I going to be able to sign up all the new business that I have to. And this is, so if you structure it well, it's all about how you structure the business, of course. And this is exactly what we have identified and sat down and worked out and perfected it over the last couple of years. And if you get it right, then obviously recurring monthly income is something that you benefit from. So every single month, you do not have to worry about so many bills that you may have to pay. You don't have to worry about so many other things. And then, of course, you can plan your life better as well. So if you know X amount of money is going to be coming to you, and you can keep the risks, a certain percentage of risk aside, then you know how you can plan certain things in your personal life, in your business life, both, right? Okay, so let's move on. Self-significance, recognition, and confidence. Let's face it, guys, we are us, all of us humans, we literally breed and would like to know the fact that we are being recognized in some way, shape or form, right? A lot of other businesses probably would not allow you to do that, but consulting does, okay? So that is an added benefit. Consciously or subconsciously, at the back of your mind, you always want to know that, you are being known in your market. Okay, and the beauty is, because consultancy is something that you become the face of your business, right? This comes very naturally, right? And you start to get recognized in your industry, right? There's something that we call celebrity authority positioning, right? That's an advanced level thing that I teach people as well. So so that's the groundwork, that's the base work, that's where it starts, right? The last point is what I felt while providing consultancy services is the satisfaction and the fulfillment it gives me, right? So for example, when I'm selling software to a major firm, yes, of course, I'm providing a solution to them, and it's incredible for them, because of course it's helping them get from A to B. But with consulting, the beauty of it is that you are almost dealing on a one-to-one basis, so you can see the smile on somebody else's face when you actually resolve the stress, the problem, the issue that they've had in their business, right? And I think that personally for me is extremely satisfying and extremely fulfilling. 80% of the people out there, that's what the statistics say, in their business or in their job, they are actually not happy, right? And at the end of the day, yes, money can come, but if you're not happy here, it becomes very difficult for you to then persist and persevere with what you're doing. So it has to have some sort of passion in it. So this is what it is, really. 13 different benefits that I've personally experienced running my consultancy business, and needless to say, it's been an amazing run, absolutely amazing run. I would say, these are the reasons why I personally think why you should also do it. Get in touch, please, and obviously feel free to subscribe to my channel. Once again, my name is Faisal Talpur. Adios.